Okay, so it's my great pleasure to open the second half of our program with another three talks from my faculty colleagues, the first of whom is Mert Demirer. Mert, the floor is yours.
So today I'm going to talk about productivity effects of generative AI, and I'm going to present some initial results of an experiment we are currently running with some software developers using GitHub Copilot. And I have a bunch of co-authors in this project. So generative AI is transforming industries, and it is now clear that it's going to have a significant impact on the future of work and labor markets. But when you think about generative AI, I think it seems different than previous automation technologies. Previous automation technologies mostly replaced low-skilled workers, and if anything, they augmented high-skilled workers. But generative AI is different because it's about information, it's about processing information, and it's about making decisions. So in that sense, it is more about knowledge workers and high-skilled workers, and early evidence already showing that exposure to generative AI is positively correlated with salaries and education level. And among these knowledge workers, software developers are early adopters of generative AI, and they can offer a leading indicator for the future of work and offer lessons for other industries. So let me tell you the evolution of LLM-based coding assistants software developers are currently using. It started with Codex, which is a GPT-3-based model. OpenAI trained this model using millions of public GitHub repositories. And this Codex turned into a product as GitHub Copilot in 2021. After that, we have seen additional tools developed by many different companies. Amazon launched Code Whisperer, Replit launched Ghostwriter, then Google recently introduced Code, and now we also have GitHub Copilot Enterprise. So we see more and tools used by software developers, and these tools have been widely adopted so far. For example, there is 1 million paid individual users of GitHub Copilot and 37 enterprise subscribers. And to remind you when ChatGPT was launched, ChatGPT was launched early 2022. So even a year before ChatGPT, we had this GitHub Copilot tool which was widely used by software developers. So we have a relatively longer history of generative AI and LLM-based tools for software developers, and that's what we want to study. So let me tell you what these coding assistant tools do. A software engineer downloads a coding assistant tool, let's say GitHub Copilot, and then starts writing the code in the preferred language and framework. GitHub Copilot reads the code and provides some suggestions. And this could be a line of code, this could be code snippets, or it could be an entire function. Developer, while coding, see these suggestions and review them, either approve or not. And if these suggestions are accepted, then it is incorporated into the code. So what is the benefit of this tool for software developers? First, to the extent that it completes, it's going to reduce the number of keystrokes. It's going to substitute to need to go online and search for different functions. It's going to write documentations. It's going to save times for software developers. Moreover, it can include the quality of the code. It can suggest a new way of coding that the software developer is not familiar with. There are, of course, some potential concerns. These suggestions could be incorrect. If developers blindly accept these suggestions, the quality might get worsened. And of course, for enterprise customers, there is open source and security implications. So these tools do actually more than this, but this is a simpler way to describe what they do and how software developers interact with these tools. Okay, so what we do is we want to understand how productive software developers become when they use these tools. To do that, we run a field experiment with 400 professional software developers. These are all full-time Accenture employees working on a variety of software development projects. These are all located in East Asia, and we study them in their natural work environment. So that's, I think, the first field experiment with software developers. There has been several lab experiments giving software developer a task. Okay, you use GitHub Copilot, you don't use GitHub Copilot, what is the effect? What we are doing here is we only do an intervention, we only introduce GitHub Copilot and do nothing else. We don't give them a task. We study them in their natural work environment, and we think this is important because an analysis from a lab experiment in a controlled environment might be different from their natural environment. So in this experiment, we started with 400 software developers. We randomly splitted these developers into two groups, 200 treated developers and 200 controlled developers. The treated group, they became eligible to use GitHub Copilot. We sent them an email saying that you are eligible to use GitHub Copilot, and we also provided them some training to teach them how to use these tools. The control group, 200 developers, they didn't have access to GitHub Copilot, though they could use different tools. They could use, for example, ChatGPT. So the only difference between these two groups is that one has access to GitHub Copilot, and the other 200 do not have access to GitHub Copilot. So after the experiment, we developed many activity metrics from the software developers, such as number of pull requests, number of commits, number of builds. I'm not going to go into details of what these are, but these are all output metrics of software developers in their software development process. So we started the experiment in July 2023, and currently we have 3 months of data from this experiment, and I'm going to show you the results from the experiment. So first, I wanted to show you the adoption rate of GitHub Copilot in the treated group. So what fraction of eligible software developers are actually using GitHub Copilot? So we see that the adoption rate after 3 months is around 60%, and we see a slow and gradual adoption. So in the first month, we only have 30% of developers use GitHub Copilot, and over time, this increased and converged to 60%. I think this slow and not universal adoption was a bit surprising to me because I was expecting that software developers are going to use this tool given the hype around LLMs and different, like ChatGPT. And I think this is an interesting question in and of itself, like why, if a software developer doesn't adapt this, what is the reason, what are the main barriers? Okay, so we collected data from August 2022 to October 2023. So we have 1 year pre-experiment data and 3 months post-experiment data. The experiment is still ongoing, so we are currently collecting data. I will show you the initial results today, which will be updated as we collect more data from these software developers. So what we do is we follow an event study design. We compare the change in the output in the treated group with the change in the output in the control group. So we look at the change in the output of the eligible software developers who use GitHub Copilot with the control group who don't use GitHub Copilot. We have many output metrics, including weekly pull requests, number of commits, and some other output metrics. But we don't observe quality, which might be important for software development, and we don't take into account the team production. Sometimes many software developers work on the same project together, which can lead to peer effects or different allocation of tasks. Currently, we are not speaking to those issues. So let me show you our main result from this experiment. So this shows the weekly number of builds activity over time for developers who use GitHub Copilot and developers in the control group. We have 1 year of data before experiment and 3 months data after the experiment. Before the experiment started, we see that these two groups follow a similar pattern. This is because these two groups are randomly chosen, so this is ensured by experiment. And after the experiment, we see a huge increase in the number of builds activity with the group that used GitHub Copilot. So it's a sharp jump, and then it comes down, but it is larger than a control group. So this suggests that there is some potential productivity increase of GitHub Copilot. Software engineers who use GitHub Copilot, they produce more output. So in order to put some numbers into this result, we compare the change in weekly output of the treated and the control group. So we ask what percent more productive the treated group are relative to control group. And we use three different outcomes: total number of builds, total pull requests, and total commits. Overall, I think even though results are slightly different in terms of the magnitude based on these activity metrics, we see that total number of builds increased by 50%, total number of pull requests increased by 20%, and there is no statistically significant effect with the total commits. So overall, I think these results suggest that there is some productivity increase of software developers when they use GitHub Copilot, but it is, of course, important to understand why these different metrics provide different numbers. Okay, so this was the main result of the paper, and as I said, we are still collecting data, and we are going to have more results as we collect more data. But let me summarize what we found so far. We found that coding assistant tools raise the productivity of software engineers, the evidence from this experiment. And we are currently running surveys to better understand the developer experience. So this is the first field experiment with software developers. And these results confirm the results from the lab experiments. In general, the findings from lab experiments typically point out in the range of 30 to 50% increase in productivity, and our results are consistent with that. So it is also some other important considerations. It is important to remember that it is early days for these tools. They are going to certainly improve, and the productivity effect could also change. And I think another interesting question, at least like to me, we see the adoption rate is only 60%. Like 40% of the engineers were eligible at no cost to use this tool, but they didn't adapt. So it is important to understand whether there are any barriers against adapting these tools into their workflow. Okay. So let me conclude my presentation for the implications of the labor market for this study. So the first, I think the most and the first important question is, will these tools replace human software developers? I think my answer is unlikely. There is still growing demand for software developers with new skills. So even if these software developers become 50% more productive, there is always more advanced tasks to work on for these software developers. I don't think these tools are going to replace software developers. The crucial question is, what is the joint production function between human software developers and coding assistant tools, generative AI? How do they interact with each other when they work on a project? And in particular, whether generative AI is a substitute or complement the work previously done humans is the most important question, because it's going to tell us to what extent it is going to these tools are going to augment the software engineers versus have the potential to replace. And finally, in terms of the policy implications, the most important question is who will benefit from these tools and whether there is any role for policy in terms of providing training to software engineers to utilize these tools as much as possible. Thank you.